everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're going to talk about controlling, as best as possible, Canadian thistle. It's something that has been around since the 1700s when it came in on crop seeds from Europe, Southern Europe and Southern Asia. Somehow it's just totally taken over because it hasn't been treated properly.
Well, it was contaminated seeds that came in the late 1700s.
They were crop seeds, right. So it came and it has loved being here ever since.
How about Minnesota?
Minnesota is covered with it, as I'm sure Wisconsin is as well. It just seems like it popped up within 5 years, but actually it's been creeping, and now it's just a pandemic of Canadian thistle.
So what does it look like?
Canadian thistle looks like this. If you want to just look over here, these are baby ones right here, and you'll say, well, that's just regular old thistles. No, it can get 3 to 5 feet tall.
It does get 3 to 5 feet tall.
If you don't do something. The roots go down 6 feet, but they also go sideways 15 feet, and they can pop up anywhere along that root system.
Well, I think they can actually grow anywhere from 6 to 15 feet deep and also 15 feet wide.
It's just, I don't want to say uncontrollable because there are measures to take. There are ways that you can control the thistles in your yard, let's say. And we have been experimenting over the last 2 years to find out if those ways we've tried is working. So what you'll see here is an area that was so full of thistles, you couldn't even walk in here. They were thistle to thistle, and they were in the raspberries. It took days just to dig them out.
Well, I thought you started a secondary raspberry bed over here. And when I looked over here, it was like a horror movie.
It is a horror movie. I have had dreams about horrible Canadian thistle. So what we did first was we put down sheets of cardboard. From old boxes, you know, whatever we would get, you know, from the store or from FedEx or UPS. We spread that down and then we put sheets of black plastic over the top of that. Now, because we had just done our water feature, we also still had some rubber, which we put over the black plastic. And because of that, this area seems to be pretty stable. And you can see there are a few thistles here and there. They will try to squeeze out from underneath and go elsewhere, but over on this area, we didn't have any black rubber left. And you can see that the cardboard is still there, which means it was pretty waterproof, but the black plastic has deteriorated because of the sun. So this is an area that we're going to have to lay down more plastic. Now, as we walk up here, you can see the walkway that has the rubber over the plastic is still good, but the areas around it isn't. But there were thistles all over here as well. It was just horrible. They come up right through the middle of your plants. They come up into your vegetables. Terrible.
Yeah, well, I remember trying to walk up here. And, I mean, last week, these two beds were just full of thistles.
Right, because we hadn't gotten to them this spring. Now, that's one of the ways to control them. Early as you can, start digging them off. Digging them out of the ground and be persistent. You can't just do it once and say, oh yeah, I got it, because you've only taken the top section of it. There's still plenty of root left. So you have to keep at them. It said in the research we had that it takes years. And if you can get them in the spring and then get them at least again midsummer and late fall, you want to prevent them from going to seed and spreading the seed everywhere again.
Well, that's how they came here.
Yes.
Well, let's show them what we worked on yesterday.
Oh, when it was so hot, we were both just drenched.
I didn't have a dry piece of clothing on me.
I never had so much sweat coming off my face ever. This was the area that we worked in yesterday when it was so very hot. Unlike today, which is delightful now that the rain stopped. Now you may wonder, well, how does putting black plastic help control Canadian thistle? For one, it keeps the rain off of it so it doesn't have something to keep it going. But also, more importantly, we're hoping it'll burn out the roots because of the solar heat coming down and cooking them. And that's one way to do it besides cutting them. This is a staple. It is much larger than what you would use in your paper.
Hopefully not.
This is a 6-inch staple. They come in different sizes, longer. And you can get them in a box of 10 or you can buy hundreds. And this holds down the plastic at the edges. So we've put them on here. We put them under that board there. The reason that we have that wire down on the ground is to discourage deer, because deer is another part of our problem here. And the deer don't like to walk on things that they're not familiar with. And then we also have extra tomato cages so that they're not, oh, let me just hop over the fence and go eat some clover, or come on in here and see what your tomatoes are going to taste like.
Well, this used to be a pathway not only for deer, red fox, and raccoons, and
right,
who knows what.
Yes. So.
But again, we're experimenting. You know, this by no means is going to eradicate thistles forever.
No.
But and I'll tell you, this is a lot easier to do it this way right now than coming in here every single day and pulling out those.
Yes, because you need protection. You can't do it with your bare hands.
Oh, no.
And another way is if you see a thistle and you can't get to it right, cut it off so that it doesn't go to seed. Once it goes to seed, it goes everywhere. And unfortunately, if your neighbors have thistles and they don't cut them back, you'll have thistles flying around anyway. As we drive down the highways, especially in the fall, we see these groves of Canadian thistles along the edges, and they have big clusters of seeds that you know are just going to take off. I mean, it's almost sickening to see.
Well, it was getting so bad back here that we finally had to not only pull literally thousands of thistles out of here. Many of them, fortunately, were very young because we did start pulling out the big ones early, but my
yes.
goodness. And then I thought, well, as long as we're doing that, we had these extra bitter-built
trellises.
And we thought, well, let's put that up as a barrier also for deer, because literally those thistles and the deer and the rabbits and who knows what started getting into our vegetable gardens, raised beds.
Of course, yes.
So, but this wasn't the only place that we had thistles yesterday.
No, let's look at that. This little corner right here was an embarrassing, horrible thing to be showing people who are looking at our gardens as something that are good. This had to have at least 500, if that few, Canadian thistles in here. That over a period of time, Rick was cutting them lower and lower, and we were putting them in the trailer and disposing of them. And then he came in with the weed whacker and took them down as far as he could get. Now, we didn't have any more cardboard to lay down, so we put down three layers of plastic under this black plastic. The black part is a thicker plastic. And over the top of this, we will put some of that wire again, just to kind of hold it down in place. Because over the years, we've put leaves in here, and they're kind of squishy.
Well, this is also a great entry point for deer, as they
yes.
graze in our neighbor's backyard on the clover, and then they jump over our neighbor's fence, both into our neighbor to the west as well as our yard.
Right. And It's very embarrassing when you see the thistles that started in your yard go into your neighbor's yard, and then they have to deal with digging them out.
In fact, you can see, I'm going to go to the fence line, you can see that they have already started to invade over here. As I look all the way down the fence line, I see them to the east, and I also see them all the way to the west.
Well, and then if you look that way into our other neighbor's yard.
Yeah, this is, now, if you can see the tall one right there, and you can see what's happening along the fence line, those are gonna get taller than the fence. And this one right here in front of us already has a flower seed head on it.
Yes.
That if Greg and Vicky don't get to it.
And I see a Japanese beetle as well.
Yep.
They're on their way.
Yeah.
But one nice thing is he's got a ground cover going, and that will help a lot. If you can get these big thistles out of here so they don't seed themselves, it's one step better than without the ground cover.
Well, I think we're going to have to tell Greg about that.
Yes.
Because if he doesn't attack it, it's definitely
right.
Not going to get any better.
Right. So rather than spraying, because that's the only other thing our research talked about, besides cutting them back and keeping them under control that way, it was to spray. And then you're using chemicals, and the chemicals are undoubtedly bad for people and animals, and we don't want to do that. So our only choice was earth-friendly, cover them up. Eventually the plastic, yes, will have to go to a recycling center or a dump, but it's better than spraying poison everywhere.
Yep.
Choices have to be made. Good luck in getting your Canadian thistles out of your yard. If you enjoyed this video and perhaps have learned more about Canadian thistles, please give us a thumbs up. We'd appreciate that. And if you want to look at some more of our informational and educational videos, please look at wisconsingarden.com. And also, if you'd like to become part of our garden family, if you aren't already subscribed, there is a subscription button over here. And once you hit that, you can go up and up to that little bell up there.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling.
That will notify you when a new video comes out. Thank you so much for watching and your support and your encouragement. Stay healthy, stay safe, stay cool. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.